السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. So in our previous hadith learning series module, we discussed some hadiths. Under the bab al-iqtibadi iqtibati في العلم والحكمة، وقال عمر تفقهوا قبل أن تصوضوا. من صحيح البخاري كتاب العلم. There one hadith we discussed. Hasad or envy is not permissible, is not allowed, except in two cases. That hadith narrated by Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu. قال قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لا حسد إلا في اثنتين.
عن ابن مسعود رضي الله عنه قال قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لا حسد الا في اثنتين، رجل اعطاه الله مالا فسلط على هلكته في الحق، ورجل اعطاه الله الحكمه فهو يقلي بها ويعلمها. Narrated Abdullah ibn Masud radiallahu anhu. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, don't wish to be like anyone or be envious to anyone.
Yes.
Except in two cases. The first is a person one whom Allah has given wealth and he spends it righteously.
Yes.
The second is the one whom Allah has given wisdom and according to it and yes. teaches it to others.
Yes. So in those two cases, healthy competition is allowed. To encourage knowledge and to have wealth, but to amass wealth and spend it for Allah's cause and give to the poor like that. Bismillah. No. Next. باب ما ذكر في ذهاب موسى صلى الله عليه وسلم في البحر إلى الخضر. Chapter. What has been said about the journey of Prophet Musa alayhi salam when he went into the sea to meet Khadr alayhi salam? So Musa alayhi salam went to see Khadr alayhi salam. So here is under Kitab al-Ilm of Sahih al-Bukhari. Sahih al-Bukhari. Under Kitab al-Ilm, so many babs are there. Here, one bab. Babu ma dhukira fi dhahab Musa alayhi salam fil bahri lil khadr. By this, then. وَقَوْلِهِ تَعَلَىٰ هَلْ أَتَّبِعُكَ عَلَىٰ أَن تُعَلِّمَنِي مِمَّا عُلِّمْتَ رُشْدًا. حدثنا محمد بن عرير الزهري قال حدثنا يعقوب بن ابراهيم قال حدثني ابي عن صالح عن ابن شهاب حدث ان عبيد الله بن عبد الله اخبره عن ابن عباس انه تمارا هو والحر بن قيس بن حسان حسن الفزاري في صاحب موسى قال ابن عباس هو خضر فمر بهما ابي بن كعب فدعاه ابن عباس فقال اني تماريت انا وصاحبي هذا في صاحب موسى الذي سأل موسى السبيل إلى لقي. هل سمعت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يذكر شأنه؟ قال نعم، سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول بينما موسى في ملأ بني إسرائيل من بني إسرائيل جاءه رجل فقال هل تعلم أحد أعلم منك؟ قال موسى لا. فأوحى الله إلى موسى بلى عبدنا خضر. فسأل موسى السبيل إلى لقيه فجعل الله له الحوت آية فقيل له إذا فقدت الحوت فارجع فإنك ستلقاه وكان يتبع أثر الحوت في البحر فقال لموسى فتاه أرأيت إذ أوينا إلى الصخرة فإني نسيت الحوت وما أنسانه إلا الشيطان وأن ذكره قال ذلك ما كنا نبغي فارتدا على آثارهما قصصا فوجدا خضرا فكان في شأنهما الذي قص الله عز وجل في كتابه. just the translation I will read first. Narrated Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu that referred to the Hur bin Qais bin Hisn al-Fazari regarding the companion of the Prophet Musa alayhi salam. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu said that he was Khadr. Meanwhile, Ubay ibn Ka'b passed by them and Ibn Abbas called him saying, "My friend, Hur and I have differed regarding Musa alayhi salam, Musa alayhi salam's companion. When Musa alayhi salam asked the way to meet, have you heard Prophet sallallahu alayhi salam, sallallahu alayhi salam mentioning something about him? That is the companion of Prophet Musa alayhi salam." He said, "Yes, I heard." That is, Ubay ibn Ka'b said, "Yes, I heard the messenger of sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, while Musa alayhi salam was sitting in the company of some Israelites, a man came and asked them, 'Do you know anyone who learnt than you?' Musa alayhi salam replied, 'No.' So Allah sent the divine revelation, that is divine inspiration, wahi, to Musa alayhi salam. Yes, Allah said, 'Khalil, he is more learned than you.' Musa alayhi salam asked Allah, 'How to meet Khalil?' So Allah made the fish as a sign for him, and he was told that when the fish was lost, he should return to the place where he had lost it, and there he would meet him, that is Al-Khalil alayhi salam. So Musa alayhi salam went on looking for the sign of the fish in the sea. The servant boy of Musa alayhi salam said to him, 'Do you remember when we betook ourselves to the rock? I indeed forget the fish. None but Satan made me forget to remember it.' On that, Musa alayhi salam said, 'That is what we have been seeking.' So they went back, retracing their footsteps, and found Khalil. And what happened further to them is narrated in the Holy Quran in Surah Al-Kahf. So the sanad is long that we are not discussing here. Still. So, Ubayd ibn Abdullah akhbarahu an ibn Abbas. Akhbara to Ibn Shihab. So, an Ibn Shihab. Ibn Shihab says, haddatha anna Ubaydullah ibn Abdullah akhbarahu. Ubayd ibn Abdullah narrates to Ibn Shihab. Then Ubayd ibn Abdullah to Ubayd ibn Abdullah akhbarahu an Ibn Abbas. Ubayd ibn Abdullah reports this hadith from Ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhu. Annahu, that is Ibn Abbas, tamara. Tamara means? In Malayal, no. In English. Deferred in their opinions. Deferred in their opinions. It is Annahu Tamara Ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhu deferred in opinion. Huwa wal Hurru. Huwa Ibn Abbas and Hurru bin Qais bin Hisn al-Fazari. So Ibn Abbas is he and Hurru bin Qais ibn Hisn al-Fazari deferred in opinion regarding what? Fi sahibi Musa alayhi salam. That is regarding the companion of Prophet Musa alayhi salam, to whom Prophet Musa alayhi salam traveled to meet him. So regarding the companion of Prophet Muhammad, Prophet Musa alayhi salam, who he was, what was his name, that was the debate among whom between Ibn Abbas and Hurr bin Qais bin Hisn al-Fazari. They were discussing the matter. Who was the companion of Musa alayhi salam? Who was he sought? Whom he sought? Okay. Then. Qala Ibn Abbas huwa Khalil. Ibn Abbas said that. What was the opinion of Ibn Abbas? Huwa Khalil. Sahib Musa was Khalil. The companion of Prophet Musa alayhi salam was Khalil. Or the Sahib of Prophet Musa alayhi salam was halı. Bu saç İbni Abbas. İbni Abbas saç. So, Hurra and Ibn Abbas was discussing the matter. They differed in their opinions. Who he was. Who the companion of Prophet Musa was. There was difference of opinion between whom? Ibn Abbas and Hurra bin Qais bin Hisn al-Hafzani. Okay, then. So, then Ibn Abbas said that he was Khalid. فَمَرَّ بِهِمَا أُبَيُّ بِنِ كَعْبُ Then, أُبَيُّ بِنِ كَعْبُ, another Sahabi, passed by them. He was passing by them. These two were discussing the matter. Ibn Abbas and Hurra was discussing the matter. And they differ in their opinions. Both differ in their opinion. Then, at that time, أُبَيُّ بِنِ كَعْبُ was passing by. Okay, then, فدعاه ابن عباس so then فدعاه ابن عباس ابن عباس called him who ابن عباس called ابي بن كعب to come in come to them okay then فقال then ابن عباس asked or told to ابي بن كعب اني تماريت انا وصاحبي هذا في صاحب موسى الذي سأل موسى سبيع Sabila ila luqiyyi. My friend Hur and I have differed in our opinions regarding Musa's companion, Musa, Sahib Musa, regarding Sahib Musa, whom Musa asked the way to meet to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then, Hal sami'ta al-Nabiyya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yadhukuru sha'inahu? Have you heard anything from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying about this Sahib Musa. Okay. Have you heard anything? Sami'a means? Heard. Sami'a? You heard. Who? Ubay ibn Ka'b. Then. Qala. Then Ubay ibn Ka'b said, Na'am. Yes. I have heard. Sami'atu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqul. I have heard. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, I have heard who? Ubay ibn Ka'b radiyallahu anhu. Allowed. So, now Rasul's words, messenger of Allah's words. Baynama yaqulu, baynama Musa fi mala'im min bani Israila. Then, Musa alayhi salam, while Musa was sitting in the company of some Israelites, was a messenger to the children of Israel. Then, you know, Musa a.s. was from among the Israelites. And he was sent as a prophet, a messenger to the children of Israel. Okay, then. So he was sitting in the company of some Israelites. And at that time, Ja'ahu Rajulun. There, Ja'a means?
Vanu.
Came. Ja'ahu, there came to him, Rajulun, a man. Faqala, then he asked Prophet Musa alayhi salam, Hal ta'alamu ahadan a'ilama minka? Hal ta'alamu ahadan a'ilama minka? It is. Do you know anyone who is more learned than you? Do you know? Anyone who is more learned than you, Musa. Okay. Then what was the reply of Prophet Musa alayhi salam? He said, Qala Musa. He said, La. No. He said at once, No. Then, Fa'awha Allahu ila Musa. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the divine revelation, Wahi, to whom? To Musa alayhi salam. Prophets will get the wahi. No other person will get the wahi. Okay. فَأَوْحَى اللَّهُ إِلَى مُوسَى Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send wahi, that is divine inspiration, to Musa alayhi salam. Then When the man asked to Prophet Musa alayhi salam, is there anyone who is learned than you? Then Prophet Musa replied in the negative. That is, no. Then Allah sent the revelation. What was the revelation? Bala. Yes. That is, Abduna Khalir. Our slave, Khalir, is there. That is, there is a person who is learned than you. You, Musa. Okay. What you said to that man is not true, not correct. Okay. Bala, Abduna Khalir. Yes, there is a man who is learned than you, Musa. Okay. Then, فَسَأَلَ مُوسَىٰ السَّبِيلَ إِلَىٰ لُقِيِّهِ. Then, Musa asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sa'ala means? Asked. To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what? السَّبِيلَ, the way, إِلَيْهِ, to meet him, to that person. The way to that person. That means, the way to meet that person. So, is there anyone who is learned than me? Then I have to see him. I have to observe him. I have to see, meet him. Okay. Then, فَجَعَلَ اللَّهُ لَهُ الْحُوتَ آيَةً. Then Allah made الْحُوتُ. That is, حُوتُ means
fish.
A fish as a sign for Musa alayhi salam. وَقِيلَ لَهُ, and it is said to them, إِذَا فَقَدْتَ الْحُوتَ فَرْجِعْ. إِذَا فَقَدْتَ, فَقَدَ means Faqada means to lose. Lost. Idha faqata, when you lost al-huta, the fish, farja, then return. So, you travel with the fish. Then, at one point, the fish will be lost. When the fish is lost, at that point, you return. Then, what will happen? فَإِنَّكَ سَتَلْقَى. Then, you will لَقِيَ means?
Met.
فَإِنَّكَ سَتَلْقَاهُ. Then you will suddenly meet that person. Who? That person. Who? That is Khalir alayhi salam. Then. فَكَانَ يَتَّبِعُ عَثَرَ الْحُوتِ فِي الْبَحْرِ. Then Musa alayhi salam went on looking for the sign of the fish by the sea. Then. فَقَالَ Musa li fatahu. Qala li Musa fatahu. Then to Musa, his guy or his servant boy said, the servant boy, fatah means the servant boy of the guy, said to Musa alayhi salam, Ara'ayta idh awayna ila sukhrati fa inni nasitu al-huta wa man sarihu illa ash-shaytan wa an-nadhkura. أَرَأَيْتَ إِذْ أَضَيْنَا. Do you remember when we betook ourselves, إِذْ أَضَيْنَا, when we betook ourselves, إِلَى الصَّخْرَ, to the rock. We took, when we, do you remember, do you see? أَرَأَيْتَ, did you see? أَرَأَيْتَ, did you see? إِذْ أَضَيْنَا إِلَى الصَّخْرَةِ, when we betook ourselves to the rock. صَخْرَةِ means
rock.
To the rock. فَإِنِّي نَسِيتُ الْحُوتَ, and indeed I forgot the matter of the fish. What was said by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The fish as a sign. When you lost, إِذَا فَقَدْتَ الْحُوتَ فَرْجِعْ سَتَلْقَاهُ فَإِنَّكَ سَتَلْقَاهُ. Okay? So, when the fish is lost, they had to
return.
But the point where the fish was lost was not, they didn't knew. Okay. So the guy or the servant boy asked Musa alayhi salam, but إِذْ أَرْأَيْتَ إِذْ أَوَيْنَا إِلَى الصَّخْرَةِ فَإِنِّي نَسِيتُ الْحُوتَ. This, did you remember when we betook ourselves to the rock? I indeed forget the fish. وَمَا أَنْسَانِهُ إِلَّا الشَّيْطَانُ وَالنَّذُكُرَةِ. But none but Satan, none but Shaitan made me forget to remember it. So Shaitan made me forget to remember the point where the fish was lost. No, I did. I also didn't remember. You also. Okay. Then Qala. Then Musa alayhi salam says, Dhalika ma kunna nabghi. That is the point we seek. Or that is what we have been seeking. That's what we are seeking. So, have we lost our fish? Then that is what we are seeking. We have been seeking. Okay. Fartada. Then both of them. Irtada means? Returned. Allowed. Returned. Raja'a. Fartada. Raja'a. Ala atharihima qasasa. Then both of them, that is Musa alayhi salam and his servant boy Fatah, went back, returned, retracing their footsteps. They were looking the footsteps, their footsteps, and returning back. Okay, going back. And fawajada khadra. Then both of them found. So, whom? Khalir alayhi salam. Khalir alayhi salam. And فَكَانَ مِنْ شَئِرِهِمَا الَّذِي قَصَّ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ فِي كِتَابِهِ. And the rest of the story, what happened further to them, narrated in the Holy Quran, in Surah Al-Kahf, verses 60 to 82. You see the detailed story of Musa alayhi salam and Khadr alayhi salam. So here, when a man came to Musa alayhi salam and asked, is there a man learned than you? Musa said in the negative. So Allah wanted to make learn some lessons to Musa alayhi salam. There is a person knowing better than Musa alayhi salam, or learned more learned than Musa alayhi salam. So Allah wanted to make learn Musa alayhi salam, or to show Musa alayhi salam some signs. Okay. So here the story, or the verses 60 to 82 of Surah Al-Kahf, just we shall discuss. Just mention. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وإذ قال موسى لفتاه لا أبرح حتى أبلغ مجمع البحرين أو أمضي حقبا. فلما بلغا مجمع بينهما نسيا حوتهما فاتخذ سبيله في البحر سربا. فلما جاوزا قال لفتاه آتنا غداءنا لقد لقينا من سفرنا هذا نصبا. قال أرأيت إذ أوينا إلى الصخرة فإني نسيت الحوت وما أنسانيه إلا الشيطان أن أذكره واتخذ سبيله في البحر عجبا. قال ذلك ما كنا نبغ فارتدا على آثارهما قصصا. فوجدا عبدا من عبادنا آتيناه رحمة من عندنا وعلمناه من لدنا علما. قال له موسى هل أتبعك على أن تعلمني مما علمت رشدا. قال إنك لن تستطيع معي صبرا. وكيف تصبر على ما لم تحط به خبرا. قال ستجدني إن شاء الله صابرا ولا أوصي لك أمرا. قال فإن اتبعتني فلا تسألني عن شيء حتى أحدث لك منه ذكرا. فانطلقا حتى إذا ركبا في السفينة خرقها، قال أخرقتها لتغرق أهلها لقد جئت شيئا إمرا. قال ألم أقل لك إنك لن تستطيع معي صبرا. قال لا تؤاخذني بما نسيت ولا ترهقني من أمري عسرا. فانطلقا حتى إذا لقيا غلاما فقتله، قال أقتلت نفسا زكية بغير نفس لقد جئت شيئا نكرا. قال ألم أقل لك إنك لن تستطيع معي صبرا. قال إن سألتك عن شيء بعدها فلا تصاحبني قد بلغت من لدني عذرا. فانطلقا حتى إذا أتيا أهل قرية استطعما أهلها فأبوا أن يضيفوهما فوجدا فيها جدارا يريد أن ينقض فأقامه، قال لو شئت لاتخذت عليه أجرا. قال هذا فراق بيني وبينك، سأنبئك بتأويل ما لم تستطع عليه صبرا. أما السفينة فكانت لمساكين يعملون في البحر فأردت أن أغيبها وكان وراءهم ملك يأخذ كل سفينة غصبا. وأما الغلام فكان أبواه مؤمنين فخشينا أن يرهقهما طغيانا وكفرا. فأردنا أن يبدلهما ربهما خيرا منه زكاة وأقرب رحما. وأما الجدار فكان لغلامين يتيمين في المدينة وكان تحته كنز لهما وكان أبوهما صالحا. فأراد ربك أن يبلغا أشدهما ويستخرجا كنزهما رحمة من ربك، وما فعلته عن أمري، ذلك تأويل ما لم تستطع عليه صبرا. وإذ قال موسى لفتاه لا أبرح حتى أبلغ مجمع البحرين أو أمضي حقبة. And mention to them, when Musa عليه السلام said to his servant boy, I will not cease, لا أبرح حتى أبلغ مجمع البحرين أو أمضي حقبة. I will not cease traveling until I reach the junction of the two seas or continue for a long period. The two seas mentioned here, Nail al-Azraq and Nail al-Abyad. The river of Nile, white Nile and blue Nile. So Musa alayhi salam and his own boy was traveling in search of Khalir alayhi salam, searching for Khalir alayhi salam. Then Musa alayhi salam said, I will not cease my travel, or I will not stop my travel, or I will continue my travel as long until I reach the junction Majma al-Bahrain, or I will continue my journey for a long period. Okay, thukub means to denote a long period. Thukub. Falamma balagha majma baynihima. And when they reach the junction between the two seas or between the two rivers, nasiya hutuhuma. They forgot their fish. They forgot. Nasiya means forgot. Forgot. فَاتَّخَذَ سَبِيلَهُ فِي الْبَحْرِ سَرَبًا. And it, that means the fish took its course into the sea. The fish escaped to the sea. Okay. Then, فَلَمَّ جَاوَزَا قَالَ لِفَتَاهُ. So then when they had passed beyond it, it is after losing their fish, قَالَ Musa alayhi salam said, لِفَتَاهُ to his servant boy, آتِنَا غَدَاءَنَا. Bring us our morning meal. Or bring us our meals. Food. This. لقد لقينا من سفرنا هذا نصبا. We have certainly suffered in this journey a lot. Much fatigue. We have tired much. So bring us our food. Okay. To take food. قال then servant boy said أرأيت إذ أوينا إلى الصخرة. Did you see when we retired to the rock? صخرة means the rock. فإني نسيت الحوت and indeed I forget there. The matter of the fish. وما أنسانه إلا الشيطان أن أذكره. And none made me forget the matter of the fish except the shaitan. Except shaitan. To remember that matter. I forgot to remember the matter of the fish. When the fish is lost, what was Allah's command? What was Allah's sign? Allah made the fish as a sign for them. It is to meet Khidr alayhi salam, they had to travel a lot. And when they lost the fish, they had to return. But when they lost the fish, they didn't forget it. They didn't knew it. The fata, the gay, the servant actually forgot to tell Musa alayhi salam the thing. وَاتَّخَذَ سَبِيلَهُ فِي الْبَحْرِ عَجْبًا And it took, that is, the fish took its course into the sea amazingly. عَجَب means amazing, wonder. قَالَ ذَٰلِكَ مَا كُنَّا نَبَغِي Then Musa alayhi salam said, that is what we are seeking. So this is the point we were seeking. We are فَرْتَدَّ عَلَىٰ آثَارِهِمَا قَصَصَ So they returned their journey. They stopped their journey and returned backwards. Following their footprints. فَوَجَدَا عَبْدًا مِّنْ عِبَادِنَا أَتَيْنَاهُ رَحْمَةً مِّنْ عِنْدِنَا فَعَلَّمْنَاهُ مِنْ لَدُنَّا عِلْمًا And they found a servant from among our servants. When they returned, they meet our servants. A servant from among our servants. عَبْدًا مِّنْ عِبَادِنَا Who was that? In the hadith, it is said that Khidr alayhi salam, you have seen. So here in the Quran, In the Quran, the name of the servant, the name of the person, he is not mentioned in the Quran. Okay. Abadam min ibadina. It is a servant from among our servants. Ataynahu rahmatan. Who was he? He was given special blessings, mercy from Allah. From min andina, from us. That is, Allah says. So from Allah. فَعَلَّمْنَاهُ And we have taught him. Allah has taught him. مِنْ لَدُنَّا From us. عِلْمَ A certain knowledge. So Allah has bestowed that person with certain ilm and mercy. Okay. Only that much is mentioned. His name is not mentioned in Holy Quran. But in Sahih Hadith, you see his name is Khidr alayhi salam. Just we saw the hadith. Then, قال له موسى. Musa alayhi salam met Khidr alayhi salam. Musa alayhi salam asked whom? Khidr alayhi salam. Al attabi'uka ala an tu'allimani mimma 'allamta rushda. May I follow you on the condition that you teach me from what you have been taught of sound judgment and knowledge. You have been given special knowledge from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, shall I follow you? Too? So that you can teach me what you have learned from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَالَ إِنَّكَ لَن تَسْتَطِيعَ مَعِيَ صُبْرًا Said, indeed, with me you will never be able to have patience. So, you cannot have much patience. To follow me, to be with me, to follow me. وَكَيْفَ تَصْبِرُ عَلَى مَا لَمْ تُحِطْ بِهِ الْخُبْرَةِ And how can you have patience for what you have not engrossed in knowledge? What you have no knowledge. So, you have no knowledge in some matters. And in such things, if I do some things, you cannot understand that. And so you cannot have patience. In such matters, to follow me, you cannot have patience. Okay. Qala, dan Musa said, Satajiduni insya Allah swabira, wala alsi laka amra. Musa alayhi salam said, you will find me if Allah wills patient and I will not disobey you in any order. I will not disobey you. You will see me patient. So Musa alayhi salam, insha Allah, such insha Allah. Whenever we mention a thing in the future, we should say what? We should say what? In? Whenever we say about a thing in the future to come, then what should we say? What should we say whenever we refer to a thing in the future? That is, I will do that tomorrow. Simply we say, I will do that. What should we say? What clause we should ask as add in? What should we add? Can we do a thing without Allah's permission? Tomorrow? Or today? Or the next moment? Can I do? നിങ്ങളോട് ഒരാൾ ചോദിച്ചു എന്ന് വിചാരിക്കാം, നാളെ വരണം, ഞാൻ വരും എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ പറ്റുമോ? പറ്റുമോ? ഞാൻ വരും പറഞ്ഞിട്ട് എന്റെ ഒപ്പം എന്ത് വരണം? ഉറക്കെ പറ ഇൻഷാല്ലാ, അതല്ലേ ചോദിക്കുന്നത്? ഖാല സതജിദുനി ഇൻഷാല്ലാ, യു വിൽ ഫൈൻഡ് മീ ഇൻഷാല്ലാ, ഓക്കെ, യു വിൽ ഫൈൻഡ് മീ പേഷ്യന്റ് ആൻഡ് ഐ വിൽ നോട്ട് ഡിസോബേ യു ഇൻ എനി ഓർഡർ ഇൻ എനി ഓഫ് യുവർ കമാൻഡ്സ്, ഓക്കെ, ഐ വിൽ ഇൻഷാല്ലാ. സോ adding inshallah. So whenever we refer to a future act, okay, whenever we refer to any future act, whenever we mention, whenever we say I shall do, I will do, I will come, then what we have to add? What should we have to add? We have to add what?
Inshallah.
What should we have to add? Inshallah. You are not saying anything, okay. Inshallah. Not listening. قال فإن اتبعتني فلا تسألني عن شيء حتى أحدث لك من حديك. Wow. He said, then if you follow me, so one condition is that, you can follow me, but فإن اتبعتني, when you follow me, if you follow me, فلا تسألني عن شيء, then ask me not about anything. Don't ask me. Don't ask Khidr. Khidr saying to Musa alayhi salam, don't ask me of anything. And say, Hatta Uhdith Laka Min Hudika. Until I make it clear for you. Until I make it myself reveal to you. Okay? Say to you. So, whatever I do, you should not ask me anything. That is the condition to follow me. Okay? Whatever I do, you should not ask me anything about it. Until I give my own explanation, my own accord about the act. Okay. That is the condition. Then they continued their journey. Who? Musa alayhi salam and Khidr alayhi salam. فانطلقا حتى إذا ركبا بالسفينة خرقها قال أخرقتها لتغرق أهلها لقد جئت شيئا إمرا. So they set out their journey until they had reached, they had embarked. Rakiba means to embark, to get into. Fisafina. Embarked on a ship. They embarked or get into a ship. Then what did Khidr do? Kharqaha. He made a hole to that ship. He tore it. He made a hole to that ship. Who? Khidr alayhi salam. So the shipmen actually, they helped them. They permitted them to embark on it, into it. Okay. But after entering the ship, kharaqaha, Khidr alayhi salam made a hole to that ship. Okay. Kharaqa. Tear it open. Okay. Tear it. Tore it. Then qala, then Musa alayhi salam couldn't bear. Okay. Musa alayhi salam hadn't any patience. So what was the condition to travel with Khidr? What did he
say?
Yes, not asking anything about anything until he revealed himself. قال موسى عليه السلام أخرقتها لتغرق أهلها لقد جئت شيئا إمرا. Have you turned it open to drown its people? You have suddenly done a serious thing. You have done a serious thing. Have you tore it open? Have you tore it? For what purpose? Did you make a hole for the ship? Okay. Did that people get drowned in the sea? Okay. قال ألم أقول لك إنك لن تستطيع معي صبرا. Then Khadr said, did I not say that with me you would never be able to have patience? Haven't I asked you? Haven't I told you that you cannot understand me? And you will have no patience with me. Okay. Have I not told you earlier? Okay. قال then موسى عليه السلام said لا تؤاخذني you don't caught me, you don't catch me, you don't act against me. لا تؤاخذني بما نسيت ولا ترهقني من أمري بسرعة. موسى عليه السلام said do not blame me for what I forgot. I actually forgot it. The condition, what was the condition? Not to ask anything to Khadr عليه السلام until he revealed the secret of his act. Okay. Whatever he do. Do not blame me for what I forgot. And do not cover me in my matter with difficulty. Do not order me difficult things. فَانْطَلَقَا Then both of them set out their journey or continued their journey. They went. ذَهَبَا حَتَّى إِذَا لَقِيَا غُلَامًا فَقَتَلَا Until they met a boy, then Khadr killed him. That was the second act. Okay. First act, what was that? Made a hole to the ship. But then Musa asked, then he, Musa questioned that. Then Khadr said, I had already told you that you cannot bear me. You cannot have patience with me. Then they continued their journey. Then they found or met with a boy. Then he faqatalahu. He killed the boy. Okay. Qala. Then Musa alayhi salam couldn't bear. He didn't have patience. He had not patience. Then aqatalta nafsan zakiyatan bighayri nafs. Musa alayhi salam said, have you killed a pure soul? Then having killed a soul, so without a haqq, you killed another soul. So a soul, a nafs, a man, must not be killed, except for murder like that, except under the decree, judgment of the qadi, then be aware nafs. لَقَدْ جِئْتَ شَيْئًا نُكْرًا. Suddenly, you have clearly done, you have certainly done a deplorable, a munkar, a thing which is hateful, which is not okay, which is not good. Suddenly, you have done a bad thing. Okay. You have killed an innocent boy. Okay. قَالَ Then Khidr said, ألم أقول لك إنك لن تستطيع معي صبرا. Did I not tell you that with me you would never have patience? Okay. Then قال موسى إن سألتك عن شيء بعدها فلا تصاحبني قد بلغت من لدني عذرا. إن سألتك عن شيء بعدها. If I should ask you anything after this. So this is second time. Now third time. So if for the third time I ask you anything, فَلَا تُصَاحِبْنِي Then you should not keep me as a companion. You can give up me. I will return. I will go. After that. قَدْ بَلَغْتَ مِنْ لَدُنِّي عُذْرًا You have obtained from me an excuse, an humble excuse. So this is for the second time I made a mistake. Okay. On my part. I didn't have patience. But if I ask you anything after this, then فلا تصاحبني. You shouldn't make me a companion. Okay? Follow. Follow. You follow. You follow. Yes. Then. فانطلقا. Then they both set out. They continued their journey. حتى إذا أتيا أهل قرية استطعما أهلها فأبوا أن يضيفوهما. Until they reached a city or a village. استطعما طعام يونا طعام طعام food طعام ما طعام means اسم الز اسم ال اسم المكان ما طعام مفعل وزن اسم المكان so ما طعام means a place where we get food it's called you heard you got a place where we get food hotel ما طعام ما طعام means ما طعام means hotel a place where we get food istatama istafala wazni istatama means they asked for food they were on a long journey then they reached a karya a city or a town or a village hatta idha atiya ahl qaryatin istatama both of them that is Musa alayhi salam and Khadr alayhi salam asked for food from them then fa abaw aba abaya abaw فأبوا أن يضيفوهما ضيف ضيف means host guest أن يضيفوهما so they didn't give them food they asked them food but they were not ready to refused to offer them hospitality ആതിഥേയത്വം നൽകാൻ തയ്യാറായില്ല അതിഥികൾക്ക് വിരുന്ന് നൽകാനൊന്നും തയ്യാറായില്ല അവർ فَوَجَدَا فِيهَا جِدَارًا and then both of them found there, saw there جِدَارًا جِدَار means a wall yes, a wall they saw a wall يُرِيدُ أَنْ يَنْقَلَّهُ that wall was about to collapse about to collapse about to fall okay, that wall يُرِيدُ أَنْ يَنْقَلَّهُ فَأَقَامَهُ then this Khidr alayhi salam, he made it straight. Okay, he made it okay, made it good. Then, qala, then Musa alayhi salam said, لو شئت لاتخذت عليه أجرا. If you build, you could have got some money or got some ajr, reward from them. Because they didn't give us food. We were hungry, we were thirsty, but they didn't give us food or shelter or like that. They didn't offer us hospitality even if we asked them. Then in such a city, in such a village, we saw a jidar, a wall about to collapse. Then you maintained it. You made it okay. You made it straight. Then you could have ask them the reward for that. Okay. They were about to collapse. So Al-Khadr restored it. To its firm position. If you wished, you could have taken it for payment. You could have taken a payment or reward. Kuli. Okay. Then. Qala. Then Khadr alayhi salam said. So. This is for the third time. Musa alayhi salam had already told him that Falatu sahibim. If it occur from my part, the third mistake, then Falatu sahibim. You shouldn't make me a companion. You can leave me. Or I shall leave you. Then Qala hadha firaqu bayni wa baynak. Ini kata. Adi. Nammal thammil idapadu. Our deals finished. okay. Deals between us finished. Hada firaqu bayni wa baynik. This is the parting between me and you. That is, Khidr said to Musa alayhi salam. This is the parting departure between me and you. Firaq means departure. Wadanna annahu al-firaq. Tuffat al-saq bis-saq. Wadanna annahu al-firaq. Ila rabbika yawma al-masaq. About the death. Firaq. Then, sa'unabbi'uka, I will tell you, bita'wili ma lam tastati alayhi sabra. The interpretation of about which you could have no patience. So I'm going to give you the details, the sir of what I acted upon. Okay. What of my acts, my doings. The three things. This making the hole, making a hole to the ship, then killing an innocent the boy, then three. Straightening or restoring a wall in a village where they were not given any hospitality or food like that. Then, amma safinatu fakanatu limasakina ya'maluna fil bahr. So, as for the ship, the first thing, it belonged to poor people working in the sea, working at sea. Ya'maluna fil bahr. فأردت أن أغيبها وكان وراءهم ملك يأخذ كل سفينة غصبا. So I intended to cause defect in the ship. As there was after them a king who seized every good ship by force. So there was a king who was coming behind them to seize every good ship. So I made a hole to the ship to appear for that thing that it is not okay. The ship is not good. Then he will leave it and these poor people will be saved. Okay. Then. So that was the first thing. The second. فَأَمَّا الْغُلَامُ فَكَانَ أَبُوَاهُ مُؤْمِنِينَ فَخَشِينَ أَنْ يُرْهِقَهُمَا طُغْيَانًا وَكُفْرًا. As for the boy, غُلَام, his parents, فَكَانَ أَبَوَاهُ, his parents, mother and father, مُؤْمِنَيْن, they were believers. فَخَشِينَا, so I feared, أَنْ يُرْهِقَهُمَا طُغْيَانًا وَكُفْرًا, he would overburden them, or he would compel them to, he will lead them to طُغْيَان and كُفْر, transgression and disbelief, kufriyat, in the future. He will lead them to future. So actually, in the Shari'at, it is not permissible. This, a boy, if you think that boy will grow in future, and in future, he will make his parents transgressed or into disbelief, lead them into disbelief. Okay. Even if then, Shari'at, in the Shari'at, it is not permissible to kill the boy. But here, Khalir alayhi salam is being given special knowledge from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Such people's act, we may not understand in the Shari'at, wahir, externally, then we cannot follow that. But they were given command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Here, Khidr alayhi salam reveals this, that is, I did all this upon the commandment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, upon the order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, upon the knowledge from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Musa alayhi salam couldn't understand that. Then, فَأَرَدْنَا أَنْ يُبْدِلَهُمَا رَبُّهُمَا خَيْرًا مِنْهُ زَكَاةً وَأَقْرَبَ رُحْمًا. So we intended that their Lord should substitute for them one better child than him, and in purity and nearer to mercy. رُحْمًا. Then, zakah, that is purity. رُحْمًا, mercy. Then, أَمَّا الْجِدَارُ فَكَانَ لِغُلَامِ الْيَتِيمِينِ فِي الْمَدِينَةِ فَكَانَ تَحْتَهُ كَنْزٌ لَهُمَا وَكَانَ أَبُوهُمَا صَالِحًا. As for the wall, that was, though it was in the city where we were not accepted, فَكَانَ لِغُلَامِنِ, that wall was for two yatim children, two orphan children. Okay, they had lost their parents already. وكان تحته كنز لهما في المدينة in that city in that village وكان تحته and under that vault there was a treasure for them وكان أبوهما صالحا and their father was a good person and he kept the treasure for the children okay but when the jidar when the wall if that wall was broken then the treasure will be exposed okay the thieves or some other people will take it and these people these children will not get it so Allah فَأَرَادَ رَبُّكَ so your Lord intended أَنْ يَبْلُغَا شُدَّهُمَا وَيَسْتَخْرِجَا كَنْزَهُمَا when they reach their adulthood when they reach their age when they grow as bigger persons then وَيَسْتَخْرِجَا كَنْزَهُمَا to make it to extract their treasure okay when they grew up so Allah wanted them when they grew up to extract this treasure so if that was lost they will not get so that's why Allah made this Khidr alayhi salam a sabab for this Khidr alayhi salam Allah asked commanded Khidr alayhi salam to erect to make it okay to make the wall okay to restore that wall okay fama fa'altuhu an amri and I did all these things not on my own accord but by Allah's command dhalika ta'wilu ma lam tastati alayhi sabra this is the interpretation of that about which you could not have patience okay so that much for today assalamu alaikum